It's time for Studio 10's Top 5 official ARIA countdown.
I feel like Bobby Fischer, always four moves ahead of my competition. Listen, they ain't gonna stop me ever. I feel as large as Biggie, swear it could not get better. I feel
number 4. Number 3. Number 2. Studio 10's Top 5 official ARIA countdown.
It's time to get all the breaking news from the wonderful world of entertainment, and here with all the latest information is the wonderful Angela Bishop.
Hello,
Ange.
Did I do a Queenie wave?
You did.
Always give good wave.
Well, I love her to bits, so I don't mind.
Oh, of course you do. Ange, George Clooney. That's all I need to say.
I think actually George Clooney, Matthew McConaughey and Channing Tatum.
Yeah.
And they're all the names of people who've been named the sexiest man alive, but that's all in the past.
Yeah.
We have a new one now.
Ooh. Who?
John? And as of today, in second place, it is Joe Hildebrand.
Right.
Just ahead of him, John O'Coleman. In first place, our own Chris Hemsworth.
Yes,
we have. Hunker, yes. And this is the photo shoot. Just get a look at that.
He thanked his
parents for putting it all together, as he put it. And then he went on to say that things should be a lot better at home now, that he's explained to his wife the people have spoken. And so he no longer needs to change nappies, do the dishes, take the garbage out, because he's the sexiest man alive and she's just going to have to deal with it.
Doesn't he look like Brad Pitt?
He does look like Brad Pitt.
Yes, you're right.
And also, like another of the sexiest men alive, Hugh Jackman, he's got a wife who's slightly older and stuff, and they've got kids, and so they don't, you know, he hasn't just done the pluck a young style at half your age out of things.
Anyway, she's model.
Oh, wait,
Elsa Pataky is a stunning model.
I didn't say she was ugly.
Nice, they've got three kids under three, so refusing to change the nappies is a very big deal.
Is he Australian?
Yes.
And he's there three brothers, is that right?
Three. Hemsworth brothers grew up on
Liam.
No,
the
brother went out. No, Liam, one in Hunger Games, went out.
I know too much.
It's embarrassing, isn't it?
Much like myself, obviously I had to knock back the sexiest man alive request, and another of my fellow handsome men did so as well.
Ryan Gosling, actually knocked it back, just like you, incredibly.
Yeah.
In 2011, fans have been complaining for quite some time why he hasn't had a Guernsey in this People magazine Sexiest Man Alive list. And it turns out, well, the rap is reporting that they approached his agent and they keep quashing it, that he wants to be taken more seriously.
What an excuse.
There you go.
I think he was just beaten by a better man on the day.
Yeah, yeah, I reckon he wasn't even nominated.
There you go. So, yes.
And Bill Cosby. I mean, these allegations just keep coming,
they do,
don't they?
They're all sort of 30 years old, but more and more are coming out each day. And the latest news is this morning that NBC was going to develop a new comedy series featuring Bill Cosby along the lines of the old Cosby Show. And they have said that is now not going ahead. That is not going ahead with development. So Netflix was going to air a comedy special to celebrate his 77th birthday. They're no longer going to do that. Now, he's not been prosecuted. Nothing has been proved. He has strenuously denied the allegations. His lawyer is issuing statements saying Janice Dickinson, who's a model, came out on Entertainment tonight, last night, and said that he raped her.
They were very disturbing allegations.
Very disturbing allegations. He said she said it happened at Lake Tahoe, that she'd tried to write about it in her book, but then his lawyers had pressured her to remove it and so forth. Again, Cosby's lawyers have said, well, that isn't what she wrote in the book at all. It was an entirely different situation. So, you know, the allegations are taking their toll. Again, nothing proved at this stage.
When would any charges be laid, if indeed they can be?
Statute of limitations.
I was going to say, is it all too late?
I mean, you can check. We'd have to check each legislation in each state.
Yeah. Right. Why the allegations is it too complicated?
Why didn't that apply with Rolf Harris, the statute of limitations?
British court system.
British correct.
But is it different in America?
It depends on the jurisdiction.
It's different in every state of the United States.
And different crimes as well. Like, for example, there's no statute of limitations on murder, for example, but on other things, like there is for civil cases and there is for other lesser crimes.
Ange, can I ask a quick question? Mm. These allegations, as you said, have been around for many years. Why have they sort of all of a sudden surfaced now with more prominence?
That is a very perplexing question. One can only imagine it's because of the amount of publicity that's been generated by him moving forward with a new television series, a new comedy series. There's been a lot of Bill Cosby, production going underway, and I suppose that's the only reason that
people
we're
people wanting to have a voice. Now, speaking of voices, we all love Kylie Minogue. She's done another film.
Yeah, a little short arty film, and it's with it's with a spectacular composer called Giorgio Moroder. Now, he's sort of one of the founders of dance music mixing. He's 74 years old. He's got a song called 74 is the New 24. Look, he did things like worked on Donna Summer songs, I Feel Love, Love to Love You, Hot Stuff. He wrote Take My Breath Away from Top Gun. And so he's done this album. He's got Britney Spears, Sia and Kylie Minogue involved. This is a bit of Kylie. We'll just have a quick listen. That's quite amazing. And so he's this terrific Italian guy and he's just created all this amazing music, and that's the little film that goes with Kylie's song.
And do we know what Sia's involvement is?
She's got a song as well. We haven't seen it yet. I can't wait. Mm. Just quietly. So, yes, that's the latest news on Kylie.
Very good.
Okay, I want to get to some serious issues now, Ange. You reported on Bono's bike accident earlier in the week, but it's actually more serious than
I was a bit flippant.
First thought.
I said he just toppled off his bicycle, but in Central Park.
He didn't fall on his voice box, did he?
He didn't fall on his voice box, but he did. I'm just going to read off the injuries. He broke his arm in 6 places. Ooh. He has a fractured eye socket, hand and shoulder blade. This was an accident in Central Park. He was apparently going...
Goodness, he had his helmet on.
I know. Apparently he was going pretty fast. He had to swerve to avoid someone, and so he's got very serious injuries. Mm. He's had a number of operations. He's going to have a couple more, and so he's going to be recovering for quite some time.
That's a bit of a smash.
Mm. How would you be if you were the person who got in Bono's way? He just went jumping around. Uh-oh.
He must have been going pretty fast, though.
Serious injuries. And you were at a very special party last night. Mm.
I was. I was at the GQ Men of the Year, and it was a huge night as some of the biggest names in Australia came out to play. And if you can stay tuned till right after the break, I'll have all the party goss. I'm going to have a very revealing chat with Ian Thorpe. Mm. The first interview with Asha Keddie as she shares her baby news. The offspring star. So that's all coming up, so don't go anywhere. Studio 10 will be right
back. Asha has her new little offspring now.